We are back for another episode of Building the Nantahala Retreat, and we're about to get some power, and that means we're about to get done with this house.
Are you guys freaked out by ladybugs at all?
Yeah, pretty much, dude.
We're like
a freaking invasion. Look at them all! Oh my gosh!
How do you get rid of them?
Just let them die when it gets cold.
Oh my gosh.
Every home needs a washer and dryer, and our first task is to hook up the washer and dryer in this one. First, I had to make an extension for our dryer vent that goes to the outside because we realized that it didn't stick past the drywall surface, and there's no way to clamp the vent on it. I used foil tape to hold this little extension together, and I also used tape on the inside because I couldn't access the outside to keep this from pulling out of the other piece of pipe, which it would likely do if you pulled the dryer out.
Wrong tour.
Son of a...
Shape it up.
Before operating the washer, remove shipping bolts.
Okay. You know, I got a washer one time where I didn't know that, and I plugged it in, and I thought the thing was going to shake the house down or fly apart.
But did you notice what this company was? Is LG?
Yeah.
You notice what they did to almost prevent that?
No.
They put the power cord through this bolt.
Right.
So you wouldn't be able to plug it in. It wouldn't be long enough cord, so you'd have to take this off. So that makes people go, why is that in there? And then they see this big orange warning.
I don't read that stuff.
Crank it out. Next, we had to put a bracket on top of the washing machine that would make this a stackable washer and dryer unit.
This procedure should be performed by two or more experienced service personnel. It says, stacking procedure too risky for one person. Should we be doing this?
Are we personnel? I think we're personnel.
I know we're not experienced personnel.
We're definitely not experienced.
I can read. I got that going for me.
Perfect. I think we're good. I got muscle, so I think we're good.
Oh, yeah. No. Yeah, see, this way, it's not going to line up with that factory hole. It's right below.
That hole's supposed to be.
I know. It's not going to work. Of course, I mean, who would have thought things would actually work?
Angle it down and...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just right there. That's not going to work. So if you run into a situation like this,
what you can do is run a self-tapping screw that has a little cutter head that cuts the hole exactly the size for the threads of the screw, and that's what we're going to do.
Perfect. Do you got any self-tappers?
Jamie's got them.
So what's on your shirt?
Come on, man. What's on your shirt?
Nothing. I didn't put that there. It must have fallen off.
Oh, I bet you didn't put it there.
Here's our self-tapping screw, and it's like 2 inches long, or 2.5, or 3. It's way too long to run in the back of this thing. So what we're going to do is use the self-tapping feature, and then take the screw out, and then we're going to cut the screw till it's only about 1/2 inch long, cutting all of this part off, run that in.
That's what I would do.
This particular self-tapping screw has wings on it, and it's made to drill through wood into metal. The wings will break off as soon as this thing goes through the wood and hits the metal, so that the hole through the wood is drilled oversized.
You may as well give up.
Maybe their buddies will see what's happening to them and be like, I'm out of here, bro.
You're fighting a losing battle, I'll tell you that much.
With our stacking bracket now installed, I went ahead and attached these supply lines to the back of the washing machine while I could get to it easily. And my advice here, if you're gonna buy these, buy the best ones you can. I've heard of a lot of people having their house flooded by these hoses failing and you being out of town and not knowing it for a while.
Who belt's coming off?
27.
I mean, it'll fit, but it's like a 1/2 inch.
strike here to knock out test cap. I still don't really know where I should hit it. It's got this arrow. Strike here.
I'll hit it.
On the last one, I don't know if you remember, I hit it and it went down the hole. And that's the problem. That can clog a pipe.
For who, you or for the owner?
Yeah. All right, homeowners, we have all the pieces. It's not in your plumbing. It's not in your drain pipe.
You want to hear the most annoying sound in the world?
Yeah.
Make it stop. What are you doing over there?
I'm just shaking his muffin up.
You can't say that on YouTube.
Here I'm installing the dryer cord, and most dryers, if you buy them new, don't come with a cord on them, just so you know. And it's because there's two different types of plugs. Here in the US, there's a 3-prong and a 4-prong. I don't know why, but usually they come with both and you have to install the one that you need for your house. This dryer also came with an extra wiring screw, which is awesome because I dropped one when I started this job with a screwdriver instead of a magnetic nut driver. With the dryer all set, we got it into the laundry room and stacked it on top of the washer before realizing that this was the wrong stacking bracket, and that's the one we got sent, so we just put it on. And that's probably why we had to drill the holes in the back instead of them lining up with the factory screw holes.
I really don't want to eat cold lunch. It's not working.
Yeah!
Maybe if we take out the
thing. The middle out.
And I'm a little bit scared of this one.
Oh, God, that is bad. It's going to be cold lunch.
No, I need a hot lunch.
No, no, no way. I'm going to try to clean this one out. It's not... Well.
I'm using that thing. Can I use the one in the house?
We could use the one in the house if we ran a cable to it.
That might be our
but
best.
If we made a mess, then...
It's better than cleaning that thing.
Dude, this will be slick as a whistle here in a jiffy.
I finished editing that video about us painting the baseboards the other day.
That's awesome.
You know what I've realized? If people actually watch this, sky's the limit on what we can make videos about. Painting baseboard, 100,000 views.
Yeah.
What do you think?
I agree.
Next thing on my list here was to get this fireplace put back together. It came with a log kit and a blower and these little coal-looking pieces that all needed to be installed. This is usually a fun task for me because it's like doing a little puzzle, and when you get done, it looks like a nice fireplace. What wasn't fun for me though was doing this blower. I should have put it in before the gas line was connected, but I didn't, and there was no way to get it in besides disconnecting the gas line and contorting my arms to where they bent backwards somehow to get it behind the other electronics here. But I did finally get it in, and it's just held in place with some strong magnets. I'll let the electrician make all the connections. Last, we cleaned the grill covers and this glass door and reinstalled them so that this thing looks like a done deal.
Man, this summer. Yo, you're kind of all over the place there, okay. Bub.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
Oh.
That's what I'm thinking.
All right, never mind.
I'm doing great. Dude, for that.
Why don't you get a real brush?
This is the best one we had out here.
Painting these exterior doors is definitely a job that nobody wants to do on the job site, so I just decided to tackle it. These are fiberglass doors, so they actually paint it out pretty nice, and this paint we're using is just the touch-up paint for our LP SmartSide trim, and it was really nice.
You just let me know when you want to swap out for painting, and I'll do that.
Yeah, just hold your breath on that one.
After getting a better paintbrush, I was in the zone doing these doors. I did 5 doors in about an hour, and that's the fastest I've ever got this done. The reason we're painting this front door, by the way, is that it was a used door. It had been in someone's basement for years, and it had a lot of staining in the wood, so we decided not to do a clear or stain finish on it.
When you're painting, try not to dip your dangle thing on your sweatshirt in the paint with a brand new sweatshirt, because then it just gets it everywhere else. See that? See that? See that?
With some rain coming in and Jason having to stand outside and use the tile saw for the master bathroom shower, we decided to have some mercy and got him a shelter built.
How do you feel, buddy? Home sweet home, right?
Oh, yeah, it's gorgeous.
It's got a lot of rooms, got good views, you know?
It's gonna start raining.
It's kind of got like a skylight kind of thing because it's kind of like clear plastic.
Yeah.
You know? You can, hey, listen.
You hear that? No, not for sleeping.
Oh.
The sound of the pitter-patter of rain on the plastic roof.
Yeah, it makes me want to go to
sleep. Tin roof sounds better.
Go to sleep.
But if you can't afford the tin, go with disposable plastic. It sounds almost as good.
We'll have this up for sale for $19.99.
Oh, yeah.
What the heck?
That's where you wash your hands. You might want to drain that.
Can't say kibbles and bits. What's up, bro? What do you want?
I can't help but notice it takes two guys to keep Jamie working here.
Two and nine.
I skinned a cat in here. I got to take all the... Every single one of these tiles has got cat hair all over it.
It's the key from getting scratched.
I gotta run.
I'm noticing that watching this in high speed is actually very satisfying, while doing it in regular speed is terrible. So at least you can see the very satisfying version of the shower happening way faster than it really did.
I see. Are you done or what? Oh, you're just looking down here.
No, I got one tile.
Jamie, see if this,
he's got my tile.
Right here it is. We're checking.
I'm just in your way. I got it, handoff. I got you. Okay. The last tile. I'm glad I got here for the last one.
Ah, you're right on time. Let me see here. Oh, you know what?
It's too long.
I like the wood trim, though. That's a nice touch. That might not last a really long time, though.
We're going to have Anton come and sand it down real good and put like 7 coats of poly on it.
You know what I love about construction?
What?
You get to do things twice sometimes. See that you get really good at it? Dryer bracket.
Yeah, let me know how that goes when I get home.
The little catches for the feet don't catch, so if we turn this thing on, I guarantee you, it would do that and be off of here. So we gotta do this. This isn't like, it's not exactly right. It's exactly wrong, so. I don't know why they need to stack these. This is fine like this.
Yeah, tons of room.
It's like Austin Powers, dude. I can't get out.
What's cool is these are actually going in the holes in the back of this thing, like the factory holes. So that should have been our first clue yesterday when we were putting the other ones on, that we had to drill holes through the back of the washing machine, that these weren't the right brackets. But, you know, we're used to just having to make things work is the problem. We're so used to that that it just doesn't even faze us anymore. Moment of truth.
Does it fit?
Oh, it does.
Okay, like good, good. Glove.
You know, one thing about this, you couldn't tell the kids to do the laundry.
Dad, I can't reach the dryer.
Oh, gosh.
Exactly.
It's probably like 7.5 feet off the ground. Seven. But it fits in here.
We need to turn that nut.
What?
We need to turn that nut right there so that the bracket, see it's hitting and I can't.
The foot.
In. Yeah.
If you've never seen one of these, the only thing it does is just keeps the dryer feet from sliding off the sides of the washer. That's all it is. That's the only thing keeping this thing up.
Great.
Listen, we got about 1 good week left out here and we will be done.
We're here for a month.
Well, that's all right.
Actually, what we need to do is we need to do a really big clean in there.
Oh, dang, that doesn't sound fun.
I'm busy that day.
No, you're right, though.
I mean, just a really big clean just to kind of, so we're grinding stuff around. But until we get the grout done, it's probably not worth
grout, finish the paint, countertops.
Yeah.
Done.
Done.
Yeah.
We're not in a big hurry, actually, because I ordered windows and it's going to take 17 or more weeks to get them on our next job.
Oh, my God.
And if you didn't know, we usually build the whole house in 19 weeks is what I have our crew scheduled for on that. So
is that going to be a problem then?
Well, we're just going to go. I'm going to go skiing in Utah for a week in a minute.
I'm going with you.
We'll keep making videos, though. They may be about skiing instead of construction for like 2 weeks, though.